Hello guys. Today, we will write a simple web server in Rust. Rust is on its 7th year as the most loved language, with 87% of developers saying they want to continue using it. Rust also ties with Python as the most wanted technology, with TypeScript running a close second. It is a multi-paradigm, high-level, general-purpose programming language. Rust emphasizes performance, type safety, and concurrency. Rust enforces memory safety, that is, that all references point to valid memory, without requiring the use of a garbage collector or reference counting present in other memory-safe languages. It has great documentation, a friendly compiler with useful error messages, and top-notch tooling, an integrated package manager and build tool. You can create a wide variety of applications in Rust from various domains. You can build command line tools. You can create high-performance WebAssembly applications with frameworks like Hue, Seed, Tori, etc. Use Rust to supercharge your JavaScript, one module at a time. Publish to NPM, bundle with Webpack, and you're off to the races. You can build high-performance web servers with frameworks like Actix Web, Axum, Hyper, Salvo, Warp, Tide, Tokyo, etc. And also embedded softwares. Today, we will write web server using Actix Web. We will check our Rust installation using Rust version. It return 1.66.1. Next, we will update our toolchain using Rust up update stable. This will update our toolchain. Now we start with our project using cargo as our build and package manager. We will create a new project with command cargo new and then the name of our project. Let us call our project Actix Web Server. This will create our project. Let us cd into the project and open it into VS Code using code dot. We have a bunch of files and folders in the project already. We have cargo.toml file. The cargo.toml file for each package is called its manifest. It is written in the toml format. It contains metadata that is needed to compile the package. Then at the root of the project we have source folder. This contains main.rs file. In main.rs file we have main function, it is the entry point for our application. This is where our application generally starts running. It only contains code to print hello world on the terminal. This is called a macro in Rust. There are many types of macros in Rust, but for now let us keep it simple. Open your terminal and write cargo build. This will compile and build your application. We can run our project using the command cargo run. As expected, we have hello Rust on our terminal. Let us change it back to hello world. Use cargo run to build and run your project. This is enough introduction. We will now move forward with our web server using Actix Web. You can add a dependency by manually updating cargo.toml file or by using cargo. Open your terminal and write cargo add Actix Web. This will check for the dependency on crates.io and fetch it for you. Easy enough. Now if we check our cargo.toml file, we will find Actix Web as a dependency. Let us go ahead and update our main function for a web server. We will import our Actix Web dependency using the keyword use. Start by writing use Actix Web. And then importing its necessary modules. Web, comma, get, which is a procedural macro for get HTTP method. HTTP server, which is a struct to create HTTP server. And then app, which is a struct to attach endpoints to our server. And then responder, which is a trait declared by Actix Web to convert Rust objects into HTTP responses. We should convert our main function to an asynchronous main function. For that we need a runtime. Luckily, Actix Web comes with an asynchronous runtime. It has a macro called Actix Web Main. Above our main function, we should write Actix Web, and our main function can now be async. Now we will update our async main function to accept HTTP requests. Create a variable by let keyword. Our variable is server. So server is equal to HTTP server colon colon new. This takes a closure. Our closure will return app colon colon new. Now we will bind our HTTP server to localhost and port. There are a bunch of ways to achieve this. We will use a tuple with two elements. First element is 127.0.0.1 that is localhost and second element is port. We are binding our UI server to port 8000. We can only access this port if it is not reserved by OS or if any other server is not using it. Hence bind method returns a result. Then we will chain the run method. We will quickly handle this result type using the question mark operator. Question mark operator terminate the function if it has an error and return in value if the result is okay. If we open our terminal and write cargo run, nothing will happen because nothing is awaiting our future server. Hence we need to await or server. In the next line, we are writing server.await. Now we will create an endpoint for our server. We can use macros to define our endpoints. These macros are annotations above our functions. They are similar to methods containing URL. Let us create an endpoint for home. And a function to return response to for this endpoint. Responder is a handy trait that comes with Actix Web. We will use this to create responses for endpoint. Under the hood, it converts user-defined responses to Actix Web HTTP response. Let us now create a new endpoint using our get macro. This will say hello to the user. It will have two path parameters. They should be first name and last name. So our response should be hello and then the full name of the user. Path parameters can be accessed using the path struct present inside web module. We will now provide the data types of both first name and last name through the path struct. Here, Rust's type safety comes into play. Very well. Now we can access these parameters using the dot operator and index. For this, we will create a response variable. This will be a string. We can create a string using format macro. And finally, we will return our response variable. Our function will return response variable. If our response variable can implement responder trait, we are good to go. We need to inform our server that it can handle an endpoint. We will attach our endpoint to app and our server can now handle respective endpoint. There is a method on struct app to attach endpoint. It is service method. We can chain our app with service method. Let's open the terminal and build the project. This might take a while. We have learned that print line macro writes to the terminal. We will use print line macro and write on terminal that our server is running on port 8000. So in our main function, above our server.await, we will add print line macro that says server running on port 8000. Use cargo run to build and run your project. Let us check if our server is serving our endpoints using curl. We now have a simple running HTTP server running on port 8000 and serving two endpoints over get method. In the next video, we will learn to serve JSON responses from our endpoints.